In our last video, we went ahead and calculated the correlation on these values, but we didn't get a significance value for the correlation to see whether it was statistically significant or not. And unfortunately, in Microsoft Excel, when we run the correlation procedure through the Data Analysis Toolpak, it does not give us a p-value, so we can't assess whether a given correlation is statistically significant or not. But thankfully, there is a workaround here, and what we need to do is, if we go to regression and select that, we can obtain a p-value this way. Now, what we'll do is, notice there's two boxes here, input y-range and input x-range. For input y-range, we'll go ahead and select the exam grade values, and I'm also going to select the label or the variable name in the first row here, exam grade. Next, click in the input x-range box here, and then select hour studied and all the values there. And then be sure, if you do select the variable names as I have here, be sure to select labels. Okay, that looks good. Let's go ahead and click OK. And then here we get our output. I'm going to expand this a little bit just to the values we need. There's a lot of information here, but I really only need a few values. And let's go ahead and highlight those here. First of all, let's make this font a little bit bigger so it's easier to read. All right, and then we'll expand what we need here. Okay, now first of all, if you watched the last video on obtaining the correlation, under where it says multiple R, in regression, if we have just two variables, like we do in this correlation example where we have hour studied and exam grade, then with two variables, the multiple R is just identical to the Pearson R. So notice how this is also, once again, 0.86. So we could really just run regression to get our correlation if we look under multiple R here. Now for the p-value, what we want to do is we can go to the ANOVA table, and under significance here, this is our p-value. And it is very small there. Now, just in case you're interested, there is also the exact same p-value when we have just two variables. Also is located under hour studied where it says p-value. So notice how these two are the exact same here. Significance F and p-value. They're identical. Now what we're going to do here is we'll use alpha of 0.05. And the decision rule is as follows. If our p-value is given by this significance F, or p-value right here, if it's less than 0.05, then the correlation is statistically significant. And since 0.0001 is definitely less than 0.05, that indicates the correlation is in fact significant. Since this correlation coefficient of 0.86 is statistically significant, that means that there's a significant positive relationship between hours studied and the grade on the exam. And we could go ahead and write these results as follows. There is a significant positive relationship between the number of hours spent studying and the grade on the exam. And then I have R, and that's for Pearson's R, 11, and that's equal to the degrees of freedom, where DF is equal to N minus 2, and n is equal to 13, so 13 minus 2 is 11. So R11 equals 0.86, and that was the value of Pearson's R, if you remember. And then I put p is less than 0.001. Now, alternatively, you could put p is less than 0.05 if you wanted to. Now, this p-value gives us more information. It is more informative than the p-value of less than 0.05. But since we used an alpha of 0.05 in this test, it would be acceptable to put p as less than 0.05 if we wanted to. But this does provide more information. And the reason why I said p is less than 0.001 is because if you look back at our window in Excel and our output, this value is less than 0.001 as it goes to four decimal places before the one appears. But it's not less than 0.0001. In any event, in most cases, when you see a p-value reported like this, it usually doesn't get smaller than less than 0.001, that's about the limit where we report it in our written results. This concludes the video on obtaining the p-value for the correlation coefficient using the Data Analysis Toolpak in Microsoft Excel.